Hi guys, welcome back. Today I'm back on the lathe project. I'd like to try and address a couple things with this lathe, some more simple projects, so that I can work my way up to something a little bit more complicated. So I figured a really good project for this would be something that's been kind of bugging me, which is this little hex nut here. Obviously it's not original to the lathe, it's a newer hex nut. It would have had something fairly long and square from photos that I've seen, so that you can take a wrench and access it here, so you can take the lock from the bowl gear and allow it to rotate separately from the cone head. So, and you can see, you can still have access to this, it does still work, but I would prefer to restore it to something more or less original to the lathe. So I went ahead and made up a sample piece, more or less what I was looking for. Screwed it on to see if there were any issues, and there is an issue with this design, and it's a bit of a safety concern, so I'll go over that. But this is essentially what the original would have looked like. Tapped 3/8-16 in the bottom, and I prefer it the hole not go all the way through. I don't know if the original hole went all the way through. Obviously it's easier if you do it that way, but I prefer it not to, just for looks. So when this mounts, you have really good access. The issue, the concern that I have is that when this is spinning at high speed, if you've got any loose clothing or anything like that going on, this could grab and could suck you right in. So I think it's probably a better idea to pull it back a little bit. Maybe remove about 3/8 of an inch or 1/2 inch from the length of this piece. And unfortunately, the sample that I made, the hole went too far in order for that to happen. So I'm gonna make a new one, and I'm gonna refine a little bit more and improve on this design. So this is what I had in mind. I'd like to have a radius corner here just for looks. It's a fairly complex little joint, but I'll just do that work by hand. I don't have any tool, really, any mechanized tool to do these flats, so I'm going to do that all by hand and use a lathe for the circular components. I also like to bevel the top off, and I've done that on the sample piece. Add a little bit of a radius almost to the top there as a nice little detail. So I want to go about 5/8 of an inch, so I've got a bit more to go. Okay, the next step I have is a little bit of layout. So I don't have any bluing. So the next best thing to bluing is permanent marker. Comes off with alcohol or oil or sandpaper. This dimension is not critical. So what I'm going to use is this carbide insert holder as the layout. It's not actually half an inch. I ordered these. I thought they were half an inch. It's a little undersized. Maybe it's a metric. 12 mil. Yep. Metric. So another nice detail that I like this curved top, so I'm going to put that curved top on. It mimics some of the other bolts and nuts on this lathe, so I think that'll suit it very well. And I'll put a light chamfer on this area as well, just to finish that part off. So this coloring I really like because it matches the original lathe really well. If you go here, it sticks out like a sore thumb. So I prefer to have something with that patina on it. And the process of doing that that I use is hot vinegar. Some people use this process for etching blades. It's an acid, it's a mild acid. If you leave this overnight, it will do the exact same thing. But if you heat it up to a boiling point, you can do that within 2 minutes. So thanks everybody for watching. That's it. I call this a pretty successful project. I oiled this up so that it didn't rust. If you do so etch with vinegar, you'll find that if you don't dry it off quick enough, then it will surface rust, which really isn't a big deal anyway. The good thing about boiling with vinegar is that the part is so hot that everything evaporates almost instantly, so there really isn't that issue that I've found. You may only find it within the threads. So that's the prototype, finished product. So it's substantially more sleek. I hope it is more or less like the original. I've seen some pictures, and I'll actually try and put this in the video as well, the pictures of what I've seen. But definitely an improvement from what was on there before, which is this just plain hex nut. All right, thanks again. Thumbs up if you like the video.